Congratulations on the purchase of your new Kvant laser projector. Before we get started, we highly recommend watching the How to Safely Set Up Your Laser Projector video first to understand the safety concerns with operating a laser projector. Now in this video, we'll be showing you how to set up and get your laser running from the lighting console. The first thing you'll need to do is open the case and pull out the laser, along with all of the cables and accessories. Inside the case, you should find your projector, TrueCon power cable, Ethernet cable, 3-pin XLR cable, e-stop button, keys, and the user interlock. Moving forward, we're going to start by using the 3-pin XLR cable to connect the e-stop remote to the laser projector, connecting one end to the laser and the other into the remote. Next, grab the user interlock from the plastic bag and plug it into the e-stop remote. Then grab the keys and plug one into the e-stop and the other into the laser projector. We will now take the TrueCon power cable and plug it into the projector and plug the other end into the mains. Lastly, we'll pull up on the e-stop button to reveal the yellow stripe, then press the start button until both LEDs turn on. This will turn on similar LEDs found on the back side of the projector. To be sure everything is set up correctly, the following LEDs should be illuminated. Power, start, and the FP4 controller on the back of the laser should be at a static green. If all these LEDs are shown, the projector is now powered and ready to be controlled. Here's something to remember. When working with multiple Kvant laser projectors, you can daisy chain the e-stop remote and Ethernet cable. As well, on lower power projectors, you can also daisy chain the power. Now that our projector is on and running, let's get it ready to receive DMX or ArtNet from your console. FP4 comes from factory with 1500 Qs and our content pack on the projector. If for some reason it didn't, we have a video covering how to upload this content on YouTube called How to Set Up the FP4 Beam Content Pack. I'll let you know at which step we know if content is on the projector or not. On your FP4, go to operational mode and select ArtNet or DMX. We'll do DMX for simplicity. Then, under DMX settings, we can select the address for the laser we'll patch in the console. I'll leave this at 1 for simplicity here as well. Last thing is the mode. We'll want to set it to FP4 profile and not the FP3 profile. Then connect your DMX cable to your console or through your data distribution. Now let's patch the fixtures in the console and set them up. We use the MA2 for demonstration as it's so widely used. We have profiles for most of the major consoles. You can search for the profile on your console library or download them from our website at pangolin.com/pages/DMX profiles. We want to use the 39-channel mode, which is broken up into two fixtures for easier setup and control. First, patch the setup profile that is 13 channels and give it a fixture ID. Then, patch the player profile, which is 26 channels, in a separate fixture ID set. These should be directly after each other in the patch and look like this. Now we'll leave the setup, select your setup fixture for the laser, go to Control, and click Setup. Go to Gobo, select Test Pattern 1. And finally, go to Dimmer, and slowly bring it up. This will show a test pattern on the laser. From there, we can go to Shapers and shape our laser zone into place. Check our safety video on how to do this safely and correctly. Once we're happy with our zoning, we can go back to the dimmer, set it to Max, then go to Control, and set it to Enabled. Before we clear the programmer, we'll park this fixture entirely so the setup doesn't change and you won't have to worry about it being enabled or not. Now you can select the player fixture, select a gobo, give it some dimmer, and you have output. If at this moment you don't have output, you may need to put the content on the projector. Check out our FP4 beam content pack video to upload to the projectors as mentioned previously. If you do have content, then you have 1500 cues at your fingertips. From here, you can do all of your normal console control stuff like position, color, and some laser parameters like scan rate and visible points. All controllable from the console and using whatever effects engine your console has. We hope you enjoy using your new Kvant laser system with a console for control. If you're having any issues, feel free to contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com. We'll help you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching.